Good morning, children. I hope you have seen the previous video where I have discussed about early nationalists, their contributions, and in the last video I have discussed about the contribution in depth about Dadabhai Nauroji, Surendranath Banerjee, and Gopal Krishna Gokhale. Right? I hope so. With their contribution, you people have understood that they were the important and influential members of Indian National Congress, and did lot many things for Indians. As well as they had a firm belief ki in the Britishers' methods and justice. Clear, everyone? Not any cause, they were not going to go against the Britishers. They simply, you know, respect and admired Britishers' methods of justice. And side by side, they simply criticized their evil practices also. Clear? Like they all, if you see, all moderates goes against what? They goes against the Vernacular Press Act, the Arms Act, right? And the reduction of age limit in Indian Civil Service Exam. So in this video, I'm going to start with a new chapter, and this chapter is in connection with the previous video, right? And this chapter name is Partition of Bengal, and in the year 1905, this Bengal partitioned, you know, it was done by Lord Curzon, right? Now in this video, I'm going to explain you why Lord Curzon has chosen only Bengal, and what was, why this Bengal was connected with early nationalist. See, early nationalist era was ended in 1905, as already explained to you in the previous video, right? Their era, they have dominated the INC from the year 1885 till 1905, right? 1905, when Bengal was partitioned, right, they were getting criticization by the assertives. They were totally opposite of early nationalists. They too were the part of Indian National Congress, right? They were not for outsiders. Clear? They criticizes their methods of justice. Clear? And how come now Partition of Bengal was there? Why Britishers have only selected Bengal? So I'm going to explain in depth in this video. So let's start with Partition of Bengal. Okay, now before starting, discontentment. I'm going to first of all made you aware why Indians were dissatisfied. Though they were discontented or dissatisfied from the very start. From the very start, when Britishers started coming to India and they started dominating the Indians, you know, Indians kings, rulers, their territories. Clear, everyone? Since that time. Indians started hating Britishers like anything. Clear? How come they have dominated and all? Everyone knows. If you go back to chapter 1, in 1857 revolt, what they did with the Indians in the causes, you can very well ascertain ki how come Indians faced the atrocities into their hands. Then in chapter 2, somehow Indians, you know, started rising against the Britishers. And that too, they started taking the positive things in the introduction of Western education and the transport and communication. Clear? But now, later on, what happened? What made Indians rise against the Britishers? So all these things really make Indians to rise against the Britishers. So many things we have done, and many things we will do in the upcoming videos. So what happened now? Let's see. Now the drought led to the famine in 1896-97, everyone knows. What happened? The very first dissatisfaction of Indians was what? Why they were dissatisfied with the Britishers? Ki drought hit the whole India in the year 1896-97, and they were not doing anything. They were not even doing the welfare of Indians, right? They were not providing them the relief and support. Clear? That's why Indians were very angry. Now next point, Bal Gangadhar Tilak, he was an assertive, through his writing supported the peasants, right, under the famine relief code. Now during that period, Bal Gangadhar Tilak, no, he emerged as the powerful leader of Indian National Congress. He was also the member of Indian National Congress, but he was an assertive. He was totally against the methods and plans of early nationalist. Clear? So what he did, he simply criticized openly, and he simply openly supported the peasants and the farmers. Clear? Now if you see later on, now after this dissatisfaction, now you will see some various policies, some unjustified policies of Lord Curzon. Clear, everyone? Now Lord Curzon, you know, implemented many unjustified policies. Repressive means unjustified, where Indians have to accept this. Clear? They have not given any justification for their activities, for their conduct. And what policies Lord Curzon has adopted for Indians, let's see now. The very first thing, he has passed the Calcutta Corporation Act of 1819, where members were reduced to half. Clear? Next he passed the Universities Act of 1904, which turned them into the departments of government. Now he started dominating the industries. He started dominating the Indian universities. Clear? Next, Seditious Act and Official Secrets Act curtailed the liberties of all sections. Now what he did, he started banning the meetings of Indians publicly. He started, you know, banning their rights to form associations. Clear? And with this, whatever organization they simply, you know, they wanted to, this like Congress, if you remember, the Congress was declared as a seditious organization. Seditious means the Britishers thought that this organization was formed to attack the Britishers. Clear? So they named such organizations of Indians as the seditious organizations. Next, the Official Secret Act. Now he simply banned the meetings publicly, right? And with this, he passed the act, the Official Secrets Act, where no Indians was allowed to attend the meetings publicly. They were not going to, you know, attend and form the associations and the groups publicly. And the, all these acts really make Indians very angry. Clear? Let's come move on to another slide now. Now, main title of the chapter now. Now, this is the partition of Bengal. You have already read about ki how come Indians were dissatisfied. They were very angry with the Britishers' methods of justice. Right? They faced a lot into the hands of the Britishers, and few Indians really have taken the, you know, step to rise against the Britishers. Right? Now see, now how come the Bengal was partitioned? Why they have selected only Bengal? Now see, Lord Curzon formally approved the scheme for the partition of Bengal officially, right, in the year 1905. The government regarded the size. Now what they did, what they tried to do now, see, they didn't want the revolt. These Britishers, they didn't want the revolt. So they simply, you know, publicly, they simply announced their move, ki why they wanted to do the partition of Bengal. So with this, they have simply mentioned few reasons, right? And they really want to convince the public, the Indians, with these reasons. Now, what reasons they have given? Let's see. The government regarded the size of province of Bengal to be too large to be properly administered. First of all, they said ki Bengal was a very large province, and they were true. It was a very large province comprised of East Bengal and the West Bengal. East Bengal, if you see, after partition, if you see later on, it changes into Bangladesh. Clear, everyone? Now, what happened? So what they did in public, what they say in public, they simply said that ki Bengal was a very large province, and the controlling of Bengal was really tough for them. That's why they were dividing Bengal. Right? So did you think is this the true cause for partition? I don't think so. Let's move on to next point now. A mere adjustment of territories. Then later on they said ki they just wanted to adjust the territories of Bengal. Right? So they said ki don't give it the name of partition. We are just adjusting the territories of Bengal. Third, bring to the Odia speaking people outside the territorial limit. Now they wanted to simply, you know, bring the Odia speaking, Odia, the people of Odisha, right? So all these reasons they have given in public ki why they were doing partitioning, why they were doing the Bengal, why they were only selected Bengal for partitioning, right? Now let's move on to another slide. Now the main cause of partition. Now see, this was a real reason behind their partition, and this reasons expose their evil minds, what they think of Indian and they, what they try to do with India, right? And believe me, children, partition of Bengal was the base for Pakistan, right, everyone? This Bengal, when they've partitioned, they simply paved the way for more division, and this time they divided whole India. Clear? Let's see now the main causes of partition now. To strike at the roots of Bengali nationalism. See, always remember, Bengal was the nerve center. You know, it was the you know, center of nationalism. If you see, you know, Rabindranath Tagore, right, Bankim Chandra Chatterjee, they all belong to Bengal. And Bengal, you know, this state was known as a symbol of unity, where Hindu and Muslims, you know, they were living peacefully. There was no discrimination. Clear? Next, to drive a wedge between the Hindus and the Muslim, to convince the Muslim for the separate Muslim province. Now what they did in partition of Bengal, now it's first very difficult. They can divide the territories, no problem. But how come they divide the hearts of Indians now? So what they do, they started dividing, using divide rule policy, and they started convincing the one community that was Muslims, and they simply asked Muslim to stay away from the partition, to stay away from the Hindus. And on that condition, they were going to give the Muslims a separate Muslim state, a separate Mohammedan province. Clear? Right? And the main purpose of doing this was what? They wanted to remove away. They wanted to remove the unity of Muslims. Clear? So they can do the partition very easily. Clear? They wanted to simply separate Muslims from Hindus. Now come on to next. They wanted to demonstrate the strength of British Raj, and obviously they wanted to demonstrate, they wanted to show their strength. Yes, they were all time powerful. Clear? Then Indians could have no political aspirations, and they thought Indians could have no political aspirations. They were highly angry with Indian National Congress growing demands. Clear? Come on to next. Now Bengal was considered to be the nerve center of Indian nationalism, as I already told you. नेक्स्ट डिवीजन ऑफ पॉलिटिकली एडवांस कम्युनिटी एंड दे थॉट कि फ्यू फ्यू यू नो फ्यू स्टेट्स फ्यू डिस्ट्रिक्ट्स इन बंगाल दे वर ऑलरेडी इनटू द प्लानिंग अगेंस्ट द ब्रिटिशर्स सो दैट्स व्हाई दे स्टार्टेड डिवाइडिंग दिस पॉलिटिकली एडवांस कम्युनिटीज राइट एंड विद दिस दे सिंपली डिवाइडेड हिंदू एंड मुस्लिम्स सो व्हाट दे डिड दे सिंपली यू नो सेपरेटेड द मुस्लिम कम्युनिटीज फ्रॉम द मेजॉरिटी ऑफ द पॉपुलेशन एंड दे सिंपली कन्विंस्ड देम कि इफ मुस्लिम्स डिड नॉट पार्टिसिपेट इन द प्रोटेस्ट against the partition of Bengal right on that condition they would give them the separate province that would be carved out from the Bengal clear everyone so I hope so people have understood ki what they did and what strategies and planning they have used in partitioning Bengal clear so they simply try to keep away the Muslims from the majority clear let's move on to another slide Now, the anti-partition movement, obviously anti-partition means stopping the partition. So this movement was started by Indians all over India and plus the people of Bengal. They started this partition, anti-partition movement. They wanted to try to stop the partition. So obviously they have protested and how come, what they have protested, what they did, we are going to read in this slide, right? Now what they did now, Bengalis felt humiliated, insulted and tricked. Obviously this was the tricky condition for them. They were insulted that their state was partitioned. Clear? Next, under the leadership of Surendranath, K.K. Mitra, Bipin Chandra, Aurobindo Ghosh, Rabindranath Tagore, the agitation spread like a wildfire. Now all these, you know, political leaders, Bengali leaders, you know, they simply agitated, they simply protested like anything against this move. And Britishers were knowing very well. See, look at their brains. They were knowing very well ki such and such things would happen if they partitioned Bengal. So what they did, they simply started convincing the Muslim community to go against the majority, to support them. And on one condition, they would give them the separate Muslim state. Clear? Come on to next. A massive meeting held at Kolkata town hall obviously the meeting they started holding different meetings in different places in Bengal right so that they can gather the unity they can gather the masses against the partitioning next the student holding the banner such as unity is strength Bande Mataram and the boycott resolution now students started holding the banner where they have written you know where they simply mentioned that unity is strength and Bande Mataram clear everyone like Bengal is one and you won't dare to partition clear so I hope so all these things really make Britishers nervous they have seen the unity but somehow they have partitioned the Bengal clear though later on it was annulled in the year 1911 annulled means cancel but with this partitioning of Bengal they simply drived they were very successful in driving a wedge between Hindu and Muslims So this way we have come to the end of the slide now, end of the video. So I hope so people have understood ki why have they have selected Bengal only and why they partitioned Bengal. So Bengal, as everyone knows, if we move back to the slide, see, if you see Bengal was a very large province, right? And they wanted to divide it for their own convenience. Plus, Bengal was known for unity also. And if you see, if unity is there, then it was very tough for Britishers to survive in India. That's why they wanted to break this unity also. So in public, they have given another the reason and in reality they have given if you see in the reality they have something else in their brain and what was there that I've already explained to you like basically they wanted to attack the roots of Bengali nationalism where nationalism activities was growing they wanted to attack that thing clear that's why they have divided Bengal and in the future the partition of Bengal play a very important role in dividing India clear why because in this while doing partitioning they have implemented at a huge level the policy of divide and rule clear everyone they started convincing another community that is the Muslim community to stay away from the protest and on that condition they would give them the separate Muslim province out of Bengal clear So I hope so you people have understood by now what happened and why they have selected only Bengal. So do listen to these videos carefully. You will get everything. Clear? Till then, thank you.